This video shows how it's possible to create a radio controlled aircraft in foam using a hot wire CNC machine. The CNC machine I built myself relatively cheaply is now starting to pay for itself. I'll be using two pieces of software, one called Profili 2 Pro and the other piece of software called DevFus. These both come from a guy in Italy called Stefano. And it's really good software. It does take a little while to learn how to use, so that's probably the main reason why I'm putting this video together, because I do get quite a lot of interest on my website on how to do this. So I thought I'd put this video together and show people how it's possible to do this. Why a Hawker Hurricane? Well, I think the Hawker Hurricane doesn't get the credit it deserves, and it's always overshadowed by the Spitfire and the Lancaster. And I already have these models. You might have seen the Lancaster on my website, so I thought it only natural to go and try and produce the Hawker Hurricane. The main thing before you start doing any of this is that you need a good reference drawing. I took the time to learn some CAD, and the program I use is DraftSight, which is a free program which is fairly easy to use once you get the hang of it. The thing with having a CAD program, you can work all the dimensions, and that's one of the main things you'll need for working with Profili and DevFus foam. You need to have your wing dimensions, fuselage dimensions, and what you can do with the CAD program is get them. The actual drawing that I've got here, I got this off the internet. It's quite a good drawing, and it's in CAD format, so you can load it straight in and then start using the dimensioning tools just to get all the dimensions you need. When I got the drawing, it wasn't in the scale that I wanted. The actual drawing is for a Hurricane with a 72-inch wingspan, which was bigger than I needed. So the advantage of a CAD program is you can just select the whole drawing and scale it down to whatever size you need. So this actual Hurricane is going to be around about 48-50-inch wingspan, which is, you know, about the right size for my needs. Once I'd scaled the plan, I then got the wing section out that I needed, and then used the dimensioning tools to get all the dimensions we need for Profili Pro, which is the piece of software we're going to use to make the wing. Here we've loaded up Profili. We set the units of measure to inches or millimeters, whichever you prefer to work in. I'm in inches in this one. And then we go to panel management. And then a new foam panel for 4-axis CNC. Type the name in. This can be anything you want, really, but this is the outer part of the wing. And then these dimensions are the dimensions we got from the CAD drawing. So we put the root length, the tip length, and then the panel length. And the sweep back, and then I put 2 degrees of washout. The Hurricane wing has to be done in two parts because it's not just a straight wing. Now we select the aerofoil. On nearly all of my models that I design, I tend to use the Clark Y, even though it's not sometimes correct for the aircraft. It's usually the best for modeling. And actually the Hurricane does use a Clark Y aerofoil. And then I've just turned the wing upside down for the CNC cutter. This makes all the cuts going from the bottom and not the top. The next section there, you can apply what's called a curve value, and that's the amount of material that's melted by the fire. This next section I add a spar, but the spar is only a dummy spar. You'll see why when we get to the next section where we add some lightning holes. It's needed to give us two lightning holes rather than one big one. But you'll see that as we go through the process. So we just add that spar, then move on to the next section. Right, here's where we had lightning holes. So the name could be anything you like, it doesn't really matter. Then if you apply automatic on there, you end up with two lightning holes. Now if you go back and remove this spar and then go back, you end up with one. So to fix that, we just put the spar back in, go back to lightning holes, but then take the automatic generation off, and then we can remove the spar. And then when we go back, we still have two lightning holes. And they're quite useful for running all the wires and down. This is where you set the dimensions of your CNC machine. My CNC machine is set with these dimensions, so it's got a 16 inches X and a 11 inches Y. We also need to set the size of the foam we're using. So the particular foam I'm using is 2.35 inches or 60 millimeters. Now the next section is showing you where the wing should be positioned. Now if you don't get it positioned correctly within your CNC machine, you can end up with the root and the tip not the sizes you expected. You can add a cut on the trailing edge, which I normally do, to give it a nice finish. Generally don't bother with the front. Now the problem we got there is because the actual wires, the cutting wire, will travel outside the path, and the reason for that is because the wing profile is too low in the foam. So we can go back and alter the actual position and move it up. You can actually add dihedral by doing this, by having a different root and tip, which I've actually done on the Hurricane, but I'm not showing in this video. So that shows the root and tip position within the foam block. Now if we go back, and then we get straight to the next section, and you can go into like a 3D simulation here to show you what would happen. So these are the parameters, and this is where you cut the left and right panel. So you have to do this once for the left and once for the right, but you don't have to go through the whole process again. Just come to that section and select left or right. This simulation is sometimes useful, but I don't generally use it very much. If something's not quite working out, you can sometimes go in and figure out what's going wrong with it. Yeah, so you can spin it around and have a look at what it might look like, and then but generally I don't use it that much. So the next section now is where we actually generate the code. So if you've only got a demo version of Profilia Pro, this is where you won't be able to get any further until you get a proper license. Once you have a license, you can put in the name of the file. Right, getting there eventually. And when we save this, we can then look at all the code that Philly's produced. It's a good idea to give it a meaningful name, because when you transfer this to the actual CNC machine, at least you know what it's for. Here's the actual CNC machine. This was just a sample piece I did some time ago, but there's the controller there that actually runs the stepper motors. And then here's the actual machine running a Mac 3 software, and that sends all the codes to the controller, and then the controller then turns the stepper motors, which moves the wire, which you can see there. And I use the eye charger, which has a foam cut option to heat the wire. And here's a picture of all the parts that have been made. You can see the wing sections, how they were made in two parts. And then above it is all the fuselage sections, which I'll go into the next video to show how they were made. The tail sections there, I haven't ended up using them because they didn't come out as I wanted, and in the end I just produced them from the plan by hand. Here's a quick mock-up of the fuselage put together, just held together with masking tape at the moment before I actually glued them all together. Right, here's a picture of the actual wings joined together with spars and servos. I'm basically ready for covering.